In this lesson, I'm going to cover the AWS Global Infrastructure. So what I'm talking about is the infrastructure that makes up the AWS Cloud Platform around the world. Now, the first concept to understand is a region. A region is a physical location in the world, and regions are independent from each other, and they're geographically distant from each other as well. Within a region, we then have availability zones. Availability zones are composed of one or more data centers, and you can essentially think of these as a cluster of data centers. Now, there are lots of regions around the world. As of this recording, there are 26, but I added a plus there because that might well have changed by the time you watch this video. AWS are constantly expanding, and you don't need to let me know when it's changed. I know it's changing all the time, and you don't need to remember these numbers for the exam. So the AWS regions are connected via a high bandwidth, fully redundant network. That's the AWS Global Network backbone. Now, each region will contain two or more availability zones. So that means that you can deploy your resources across availability zones, and you get lots of redundancy by doing that. There's also something called a local zone, which we'll go into in a bit more detail shortly. Local zones extend regions closer to your end users. Really, that's for reducing latency. Latency is the delay over a network. Typically, the farther you are from a specific service, the more latency there's going to be across that network. So let's look inside a region in a bit more detail. So within a region, as I mentioned, there are two or more availability zones. Within those availability zones, you can create your subnets. They can be public subnets or private subnets. And each subnet is always within an availability zone. And you can create many, many subnets. Availability zones are one or more data centers. Each availability zone is composed of one or more data centers. And each of those data centers will have redundant power sources. You also have redundant networking within each of the data centers. So there's lots of redundancy for power, for cooling, for networking, for all of the resources on which the cloud services depend. So you can then deploy your resources across subnets and availability zones, and you get lots of high availability for your applications. So what other components are there? So let's say we have our region here with some availability zones and we've created our subnets. We might want to extend some of the services into our on-premises data center within our company. So we can use AWS Outposts to do exactly that. With Outposts, you can run some AWS services on dedicated hardware within your own data center. And that means that you've got really low latency access, and you can develop and build your applications within your own on-premises data center. We also have local zones. So local zones help you to get AWS services closer to your end users. And that means you get lower latency, so less delay over the network because they're closer than the region might be to wherever you actually are or your users actually are. We also have something called a wavelength zone. This is also about getting your services to your end users, but in this case, via a 5G network. So users can connect with low latency over their 5G networking to services that you're running in the wavelength zone. And those are all connected to your AWS region as well. So what are the use cases for AWS Outposts? We would use it to get AWS services running in our on-premises data centers, and so that we can use AWS APIs on-premises. For wavelength zones, this is about getting single-digit millisecond latency to mobile devices and end users. It's good for live video use cases, machine learning, augmented reality, and virtual reality. And then lastly, for local zones, we want to use these for single-digit millisecond latency to our end users and applications, and again for similar use cases as the wavelength zone. Another important part of the AWS Global Infrastructure is regional edge caches and edge locations. These are part of the CloudFront network. CloudFront is a content delivery network service, a CDN, And essentially what we use these for are to get content closer to our end users for better performance. So for example, we might cache video files or images in the edge locations that are close to our users around the world. And there are many edge locations and regional edge caches. So that means the latency is lower and the users can download or watch those videos without having to go a long distance around the world to get them. So that's the CloudFront network. And of course, again, these numbers are subject to change. Lastly, I'll just show you the actual numbers for the AWS Global Infrastructure today. As I mentioned, these numbers change all the time, so you don't need to let me know when they change. I'm aware of that. And it's not important for the exam to know any exact numbers for the number of regions or AZs. You just need to understand the basic concepts around these different parts of the global infrastructure. But it's good to get an understanding of how many of these there are around the world.